nine courses in County Seafood. I don't care who speaks today, but I think it just should be randomly my oldest child. Research shows us that's John Leonard McGoldrick. He's a masterful speech maker. Johnny McGoldrick, round of applause for you.
Do a wee few lines, so you just be with me. First of all, I'd just like to especially welcome Brother John Paul, my beautiful Auntie Stephanie, and my beautiful Auntie Pamela. On behalf of my mother, Mary Carmen McGoldrick, I am particularly proud to welcome you all here today as well. Fancy that, 90th birthday, eh? It's not bad, is it? Considering she must have had me when she was about three. We are indeed very privileged to be able to celebrate with this very remarkable lady. She's been a wife, a sister-in-law, a mother-in-law, a grandmother, a great-grandmother, an aunt, and a friend to so many people. I think it's a testament to the fact that there are so many here today, there's so many that we actually had to knock back and wanted to come and we had to say no to. She's touched so many lives, as you can see from all this big crowd and the words that have already been spoken. To say that she is respected is a gross misunderstatement. Anyone who has come into her presence is immediately struck with how friendly, how hospitable, how interested she is in you and your family, and how easily she will relate to you. Carmel McGoldrick is our matriarch.
Yeah.
She has created this dynasty, and as you can see by her 23 grandchildren and 7 great children, the dynasty is in very good hands. Carmel is the most positive person I know, and as we all know, she's extremely sociable. And how she loves a party, she hates to be left out of anything and everything. Despite the fact that her hearing is shot, her eyesight marginal, although Paula might beg to differ after a trip to Nelson last year when she was reading all the street signs and road signs. Even after she did that little involuntary somersault down the steps last November and the other illnesses that have already been mentioned, nothing holds her back. Determination is a top word in her vocabulary. 6 Roxton Terrace is her home and one where you are always welcome. There's usually, in fact, often enough she leaves the door unlocked daily in. And you just walk right on in. There's usually a gin or a wine or a beer, and chances are you might be invited to have a drink with her. She will make you most welcome. She, as I said, she's interested in everyone, especially her fantastic grandchildren, their partners and their children, and she's proud, as you can hear, to espouse their virtues. While you're there, the phone rings often, and the news of the family filters through. Great for us here in Christchurch because she's the oracle and we do pick up on all the news. Carmel is a woman with amazing faith and she has a powerful relationship with her God. We can see that in the beauty of her heart and in her spirit. The good Lord Jesus Christ, I'm sure, is together with her as one. And we're all blessed to have her in our lives through her constant prayer and devotion to her family. Carmel and Lynn had 8 children. She is the glue in our family and we take inspiration from her every day. Nothing's ever a problem to her. As young people growing up in Timaru, our house was always welcome. Hello, James. This is my eldest grandson, if anybody's interested. drive around with our friends, and it just happened to be dinner time. Miraculously, she would appear with a spud and a chop or a piece of steak. As if cooking for a husband and 8 children wasn't enough. She was a magnificent cook, and her meals were always sumptuous affairs with meat, spuds, and about 12 veggies. Ah, the good life. Oh, I didn't mention the puddings either. We always did. However, as we know, Carmel did not cook on a Friday night, but she was always welcome for a gin or two. In fact, the tradition continues. Party at Mama's Friday night. My mother is such a smart woman, and I personally seek her advice often. Not that I sometimes take it, but sometimes I do. She has many interests that keep her so busy. She absolutely loves her bridge. Only down to about 2 or 3 times a week now. Her marvellous friends arranged to come and pick her up. They sort out her cards for her and then deliver her home. Cricket and rugby are her other passions, although they may rank slightly behind horse racing. The balance in her TOB account fluctuates wildly on a Saturday while she's glued to tracks on. She loves the Black Caps and never misses a game, although she gets very grumpy when they lose. Oh, Guppy's not here just as well. Her and I love the rugby season and often compare notes after a big game, although she tends to leave me alone after the Crusaders lose. Thank goodness that's not often. My brothers and sisters are extremely lucky that they're actually here tonight, and they're only so because I was such a great baby. Being the firstborn, and privileged as I am to be able to make this speech, thank you, Phil. My mother was initially not too cracked up about childbirth and everything that came with it, and was adamant that I would be the last. You know, the first shall be the last. However, I turned out to be such a perfect child, she decided, hey, maybe if they turned out like me, then she might try for more. And of course, another 7 popped out. My brothers and sisters will have many anecdotes to share with you, precious memories of our beautiful mother Carmel. I know that you will all have fantastic stories to share. Let's enjoy the day, and I won't be surprised if we might not be back here on or about the 13th of February 2028 to celebrate another milestone. Thank you, Carmel, for your life, your amazing love, and the great memories you have given us, the amazing friendships you have made, and especially just for being you. One hell of a kind. As they say, they broke the mold when they made you, Carmy. Happy birthday, Mother.
Thank you. Yay! Johnny! Outstanding.
Thank you, Phil. I would just like you all to charge your glasses. And I want you to all stand to your feet.
That's good.
And let's raise our glass to the most magnificent woman you're likely to ever come across.
It's coming! Ching ching. Good footage, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Cheers, Jamie Fox. Maria.
Enjoy your main courses, keep moving, mingling, and enjoying yourselves.